Welcome, everybody. Today, we are going to make this cool tag that I learned from a tutorial by one of my favorite junk journal artists, and her name is Natasha, but she goes by Treasure Books. So on one of her tutorials, she had like five things that she made, and this was one of them. She made it a lot more elaborate than mine. She had charms hanging from it and just all kinds of cool stuff and stuff on the inside. But this is what we're going to make today, and then you can embellish it however you want. So what you need is a template for a tag, which I had created, so you can copy the dimensions. Let's see if I can get that to show. No? Okay. Never mind. There's the dimensions. It's 4 3/4 tall, 3 inches wide, and then each one of these little corners is 1/2 inch from the ends. And that's what this one is, and that's what I'll use as a template. So really, what we're going to be doing is cutting out one piece of paper this size. But what we're going to do first is fold it so that when we cut, it ends up cutting this whole thing. And therefore, when you fold your paper, you need to remember to cut at where your folds are so that when it opens out, it's all connected. Otherwise, my first attempt, I had 4 separate ones because I didn't realize you needed to cut at, you know, cut so that you had the 2 folds. So I'm gonna start with this piece of paper. And what we're going to do is fold it hamburger style, which is fold it the long way in half so that it's shorter. And then we're going to fold it. Let me see. It's hard to try and figure out if you want it to be right way up. But anyway, so hamburger and then another fold this way. And you just end up with a little rectangle like that. Give it a nice sharp fold, nice sharp crease. And then when you use your template, remember to make sure that this corner, here is part of this tag and that this end is the same as here where it's folded. So line up your template with the 2 folded edges, and then you can trace around it. I find that's the easiest way to do it. And it doesn't have to be exact. I mean, you can make your tag any shape you want it, but this is sort of your basic tag shape, right? I mean, we've all seen tags that are this shape. And then just cut it out like this. And it's handy if you have a hole punch, but you really don't need one. Just, you're going to be punching a hole here, but only on the first one. You're not going to punch it all the way through. Let's see if I did this right. Yes. Okay, good. So you should have something that looks like this, where you have 4 tags, but they're all folded up together, and this will be the front. And so what I'm going to do next is find a paper that'll go on the inside. If you wanted to, you could just have a decorative paper on the inside, or if you wanted to use it for a journaling tag or something, then you probably want to find some kind of paper that you could write on. And I have this really nice brown craft paper. I'm going to put that on the inside. And so what we're going to do is on the inside of our folded piece, we're going to just glue all of this with a glue stick or white glue or whatever you have. I have some tacky glue handy. Let's see. I have this, which you've all seen, I'm sure. And I'm just going to coat this whole thing, if I can get it to work. There we go. Lots of glue. I'm not sparing any corner or any fold. All of it gets glue. And I have some water nearby so I can clean my brush after, because this stuff can really ruin a brush. I don't know if any of you have experienced that, but you really do need to wash it well after you use it for glue. I like Murphy's oil soap is really good for cleaning brushes, and also something called pink stuff or pink. Yeah, I think it's called the pink stuff, and it's pink and it's stuff in a bottle, and it's really good for cleaning brushes. So if you look up brush cleaners or pink stuff or any of that, you'll find it. Okay, so you want to get every little corner, and then you're going to just turn this over and press it down. Get that down on your second piece of paper. Now, if you were really clever and planning ahead, my guess is you could have cut both at the same time. And I'm not sure why we don't do it that way, but you might want to try it. Right? I mean, we could have cut two when we did our folds and everything. And now we're just gonna cut around this one. So they're all lined up and neat. But yeah, I really feel like we could save this step, but I don't know about you. This is very satisfying cutting paper. How many of you liked paper dolls and cutting out paper doll clothes? I think that was one of the great pleasures of childhood. Not these computer generated things that you just, that are stickers. And I mean, we had to work to make our art. We had to cut stuff out and glue it down with that wonderful paste. And then just this and this. And ideally, you would let all of that dry. But for the sake of time, we're going to just fold it while that glue is still wet. If you used a glue stick, it might not take as long. So again, we're going to fold it in half, just like with the original. Give it a good crease. What am I doing? We want to fold it in half so that's on the inside, right? That's what our intention was. Now it'll be a little harder to crease it because it's two layers. And then this way. And it's going to have some imperfections. Because guess what? Everything has imperfections. But you can trim this edge. Just don't trim here or here, right? But you can trim that off. And I'm going to just do a little trim right there. Okay. And then, like I said, you're only going to put a hole if you want to make a tag hole. To put a ribbon or something. So you just want to put it in that one spot. There's my punch. Okay, so we're going to just put a hole right in the middle here on the first one. Well, that's a little close to the edge. Don't do what I did. Do what I say, not as I do. You want it down a little further, ideally. And then you can, what Natasha did was she cut out two pieces of other paper and put them here and here. So they were just a little smaller than the tag size. And I have some really pretty papers, sort of decorative designs. And I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to fold this in half. Can't remember where this came from, some printable something. And I'm going to cut it out this shape, but then I'm going to cut it down because this is too big, right? So let me just get it started here. I need two of these, not folded, just two. See if I can tear it. Well, that's okay, because we're going to trim it down. So first I'm going to cut it to this size, and then I'm going to make it smaller. And I'm sure there's a more scientific way of doing this with rulers and stuff, but I'm just winging it here. I think it's going to be okay, however this works out. And then here. Okay. Now I have these two pieces. And I'm going to make them quite a bit smaller. So in fact, I think I'm going to just cut them into a rectangle like this. Don't need it to be all fancy. Just want to fill in that space because I'll probably end up doing a collage on top of it. So like this. And a little bit less width. Okay, I might have wanted to cut that a little straighter. Now, there. I think that's better. Let's see. Get a little more glue on there. I think I'll use a glue stick this time, if I can open this. And I can. And again, this is just the guide of how to make this, but obviously you'll have your own ideas of how you want it to look and what its function is going to be. So I just wanted you to see how to construct it, and then it's up to you to figure it out. If you want to collage it, if you want to journal on it, you know, if you want to have like a little story starting here, 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 and then you open it up, all kinds of things you can do with this. And then you just need a little piece of ribbon or just some little thing. Let me just cut a little piece of ribbon. This is great. Starry ribbon that's polka dots. I love it. But I'm going to be real careful because that is so close to the edge and it's torn. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut this down and just have a shorter tag. And this time, when I cut the hole, when I punch the hole, I'm going to do it down further. There, just that first one, right? Okay, now push the two layers through, make a loop, push these through. And so this part comes down to the front and then very gently pull it. You don't want to rip that hole. And then just trim that off. Okay. And like I said, with treasure books, she actually added a charm hanging down here. She put a jump ring and, you know, she knows how to do like jewelry and stuff. But what I did, and I just did one of my little embellished paper clips to hold it all together. And I think that ends up looking real cute. And like I say, there's lots of different ways you can use these. This is just a structure that can be just really fun to play with. And I hope that you have fun making it your own. Okay.